The creation. The Supreme Lord, the Infinite, the Paramatman, Purushottama is all-pervading, all-powerful and all-knowledge. He is pure, faultless and free from all actions. He is an Upadrishta or Sakshi and he simply witnesses the play of Prakriti in his divine presence. But during the great deluge, nothing remains except himself. The whole universe merges into him and he is called at that time as Vishwagarbha. All that had an existence earlier find a place in him in their casual form. He ceases to be an Upadrashta also at that time, as there exists nothing other than himself. If he is pleased to remain in that state forever, there will be no creation at all. But his power called Prakriti does not remain quiet. It is propelled by his another power called time. And then the Prakriti begins to slip out as Satya, Rajas and Tamas. These three functions are described as the function of Ishwaramsa and are named separately as creation, sustenance and dissolution. The first process of creation is the emergence of the Mahatattva, which is the gradual reappearance of the casual forms of the universe, which existed before the great deluge. It is also called as Maya, ignorance, avidya, unmanifest, and Prakriti. The second process is the evolution of Ahankara or ego. This Ahankara is created only when there is the object, body, knowledge, I, and action, superimposition of The third process is the evolution of the subtle elements as sound, touch, form, taste and smell, and then the gross elements as the space, wind, fire, water and earth. The fourth is the evolution of the organs of sense perception and organs of action. That is ears, skin, eyes, tongue and nose, speech, hands, legs, sexual organs and organs of defection. The fifth is the evolution of the mind, which is born of the Sattvika Ahankara. The sixth is ignorance, Avarana and Vikshepa, born of Tamasika Ahankara. These six are fields provided by Prakriti for Ishvara to play his Leela, the Leela Kaivalyam. Then the fields provided by Vikriti or Brahma. The seventh is the variety of immobile creatures, plants and trees, which are of six varieties. 1. Trees which bear fruit without flowering, as the banyan, fig, jack and peepal. 2. Annual plants and herbs, all grain crops and vegetables. 3. Creepers that require support, as the grapes, jasmine, etc. 4. Plants which are useful only for their bark, as the bamboo. 5. Creepers which do not require any support but spread on the ground and bear fruit, like the pumpkin and watermelons. 6. The trees which bear flowers and fruit, like the mango. All these draw their nutrition from below. They have some sense of touch but cannot comprehend anything external. The eighth is the evolution of animals. They take their nutrition horizontally. They have no sense of time. They are irrational and are led by instinct. They perceive with their sense of smell and select which they desire. Of these, there are bifurcated hooves varieties, as the cow, bull, buffalo, sheep, goat, deer, etc. The unbifurcated varieties, as the horse, donkey, etc. Animals with five claws, as the dog, cat, tiger, hare, monkey, elephants, tortoise, etc. These are the birds, as crow, hen, peacock, swan, hawk, vultures, etc. The ninth is the evolution of the human race. Their nutrition moves downwards. They are mostly full of rajas. They take delight in the pleasures of the sense organs and so are rooted in sorrow. These are all the living and visible creatures, movable and immovable, that are manifesting as trees, beasts, birds, and human race. The tenth is that of invisible gods. They are born of sattva ahankara. They preside over the sense organs and the organs of action. These are the many varieties that come out by creation and appear as the universe. They remain to be sustained for a varied period of time and finally get dissolved to go back to that one thing out of which all these came out. These are only different manifestations of that one thing. All these are therefore that one thing which feels all these as a play to manifest in different forms. This is called his Leela, the Leela Kaivalyam of Paramatman. All the pots are only mud. All the ornaments are only gold. All the waves are only the ocean. Therefore, the Upanishads repeat, Tat Tvam Asi, thou art that. Brahman is one. Learned people express in different ways. Ekam Sat, Vipraha Bahudha Vadanti. Brahman is truth. World is only a misconception. Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya. For the Lord has said, Vishvabhyahamidam Krishnam Ekam Sena Stito Jagat. All this perceptible world is not only me, but also it is only a fraction of me, and truly it is nothing other than me in the Gita.